Wait.
Edgar Bergen and Charlie McCarthy. With Ray Noble and his orchestra, yours truly, Bill Goodwin, Charlie's guest for this evening, the lovely singing star, Ginny Sims, soon to be seen in Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer's Technicolor production, Broadway Rhythm, and the beautiful Paramount star, Miss Veronica Lake.
Ginny!
Hello, Charlie.
Hello, Miss Sims. Miss Sims, you know, Ginny, you make me feel so safe. How about you and I just stepping out tonight, Ginny?
Well, I don't know now.
I see. You're not sure, huh?
You must remember, Charlie, that Ginny Sims is the sweetheart of 9 million servicemen.
Yeah? 9 million.
Yes.
That's a lot of competition to overcome.
Yes.
But I'm just a fool who's going to try it, you know?
Now, I don't know when I'd find time for you, Charlie.
Oh.
You see, when I'm not visiting army camps, I'm knitting sweaters for the servicemen.
Oh, are you?
Uh-huh.
How are you coming with your knitting now, Ginny?
Well, not so well. I sent a sweater to Camp Hahn 3 months ago, and they haven't used it yet.
Oh, no.
Well, now, that's ungrateful. How come?
See, they're still looking for a soldier with 3 arms.
Oh, is it?
Well, I guess being the sweetheart of all those fellas, that sort of keep you pretty busy, doesn't it?
Well, I try to please them all. When I go out with a private, I hold his hand.
Uh-huh.
When I go out with a captain, I give him a great big hug.
No. Well, she ends with an old general.
Oh, you're sweet, Charlie.
Yeah.
You know, I'm going to sing a song just for you.
Oh.
And for my 9 million boyfriends, too.
Oh.
When you're down and out, nothing to shout about. There's gonna be a great day. Angels in the sky promise that by and by there's gonna be
up your head and shout, there's gonna be a great day.
Hallelujah!
Angels in the sky promise that by and by there's gonna be a great day.
Gabriel will warn ya, some early morn ya, we'll hear his horn, Rudy Tootin'.
It's not far away, lift up your head and say, there's gonna be a great day, a great day, a great day.
Oh, Ray. Oh, Mr. Noble.
Oh, what is it, Charles, my boy?
I suppose you heard about poor Bergen.
No.
Oh, didn't you hear about the tough break he's had?
No, what's happened?
Oh, he's in a jam over money.
Oh.
Yes, his...
Oh.
His bank book has had an unhappy ending.
You don't say, eh?
He's lost his shirt, Ray.
Oh, lost his shirt?
Yes.
Oh, well, the laundries are so careless these days, anything could happen.
No, this is no joke, Ray.
No?
No, Bergen has lost all his money. He's broke, Ray.
You and your slang, Charlie. You mean he's strapped? He's over a barrel.
Oh, Ray, he's wearing it, I'm telling you.
Well, how did you find out?
Well, you see, Bergen, he was on the phone.
Uh-huh.
And I was accidentally listening through the keyhole.
Accidentally, yeah.
Yes. All right, I was listening, I'll admit.
Oh, I just noticed it, that's all.
Well, I picked it up.
Yes.
And I heard him say that he was wiped out in a big deal.
Oh, no, not really.
It's the truth. I feel so sorry for him, you know.
It's really bad, isn't it?
So helpless, you know.
Oh, I know. A man can't do a thing without you.
Oh, no, no. So he said, I heard him when he said it, too. He said they took him for every cent he had, see?
Oh, golly, I see that. This is something. Bergen parted from his money.
Yes.
Oh, dear.
Means so much to him, too, you know.
You said it.
That is breaking up the biggest love affair since Romeo and Juliet.
Well, after all, Charlie, perhaps his friends will help him.
Well, you see, Ray, Bergen has been a ventriloquist for 15 years now, and he just doesn't have any friends now.
Well, after all, you know, Charlie, there's no disgrace to being poor.
No?
It's just so uncomfortable.
Yeah. This is not funny, Noble.
Well,
you know, we should be ashamed of ourselves for making these jokes like this.
Yes, I guess so.
We should really be ashamed of ourselves.
Singing songs in a cabaret, was I having fun?
What?
Singing songs in a cabaret.
Don't bother, Bergen, please. Please, don't try.
What do you mean?
Don't try, Bergen.
What's the matter?
Don't try to be gay.
Oh, no. Try to be gay?
No, I understand.
But I feel fine. I am gay.
You are gay?
Yes, yes. Everything is hunky-dory.
Hunky-dory?
Yes.
It's hunky-dory?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Just fine?
Yes, just fine, of course.
You're happy?
Yes, yes.
You and your silly pride.
No. What are you talking about?
You're with friends now, Bergen. Friends. You know?
Yes. What do you mean?
Why? You don't have to worry too much about your future.
What do you mean, Charlie?
Well, you know that old saying, Bergen, that rats desert a sinking ship?
Yes, I've heard that.
Well, I'm one rat that's sticking.
Oh. Well, what is this silly chatter, will you tell me?
It's a pal talking.
Pal? I see.
I'll stick with you, Bergen.
I see.
Did David desert Goliath? Did Chase desert Sam Bourne? So don't worry, Bergen. I put you on top once. I guess I can do it again.
I see. Well, Charlie, I appreciate your display of loyalty, but I don't quite know what brings it on.
You don't know?
No.
Go ahead. Play it straight face if you want to. Be a Pagliacci. Go ahead. But I just want you to know that I'm with you, pal.
Are you, Charlie?
Yes.
Oh, that's good.
Yes, Bergen, I've been thinking, too, lately.
Yes?
You know that 75 cents I get a week, my allowance?
Yes.
It's more than I need.
It's more than you need? Well.
As a matter of fact, it's too much.
It's too much.
Yes.
Well, I'm glad to hear that, Charlie.
And there's something else I've never told you.
No.
You know, I've got to... $11.80 hidden.
Is that so? $11.80.
Mm-hmm.
I see.
$11. Uh-huh.
Well, it's not in your piggy bank.
No, it isn't. See, I know you'd look there.
Oh.
So I've hidden it in my catcher's mitt.
In your catcher's mitt.
Uh-huh.
I see.
And it's all yours, Bergen.
Well, Charlie.
You could even have the catcher's mitt.
Well. But tell me, Charlie, what have I done to deserve this?
Oh, you've been good to me. Kind to me. Kind and generous. Well, anyway, kind.
Yes. By the way you're talking, you'd think I was headed for the poorhouse.
Well, I hope it's not quite that bad. Of course, you can always go into vaudeville.
Oh, you still think I can go back to that?
Yes. Oh, they must have forgiven you by now.
Yes.
Vaudeville. We've been through a lot together, haven't we, Charlie?
Yes, yes. But you went through the bankroll by yourself.
Well, I'm glad you still have confidence in me, Charlie. It means a lot.
We can start all over again from the beginning.
Yes.
And this time you can work, too.
Yes. But what is all this, Charlie? Why, you talk as if I'd lost my money.
Well?
Well?
Haven't you?
Hmm? What makes you say that?
Well, yesterday I heard you say over the phone that you had lost everything.
I had lost everything?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Why, you must mean that bridge game that I got into over at Veronica Lake's house.
Bridge game?
Yes, yes. You see, there were some pretty good players there, Charlie.
Yes?
Yes, and I'm afraid they sort of cleaned me.
Well, how much did you lose?
Well, I lost $2.86.
They cleaned you of $2.86? You weren't very dirty, were you?
No.
How did you happen to be carrying such a wad on you?
Well,
took it right on the nose for $2.80.
Yes, I did, Charlie. But I want you to know, Charlie, that it's worth losing that money to know that you're such a loyal friend.
Well, I don't know about that.
And I won't forget what you said about your allowance and taking a cut.
Well, now, wait a minute out there, you know.
Listen, Charlie, I appreciate...
No, I didn't put anything in writing.
Now, Charlie, no.
Charlie, let go of my lapo. Charlie. You.
Didn't you say, Charlie?
You. Let go of my lapo, Bergen.
All right.
I'm getting out of here.
Where are you going?
I'm going to hide my catcher's mitt.
Oh, my God.
From...
Like all visitors to New York this year, Jimmy Sims made a pitch for tickets to the one show everyone wants to see, Oklahoma. Well, Jimmy knew a friend who knew a friend, and she saw the show. And to commemorate that major victory, Jimmy sings, "People Will Say We're in Love," from Oklahoma.
Edgar, could I see you for a minute?
Well, Veronica Lake. Charlie, you remember Veronica Lake?
Of course. Hello, Miss Lake. I know your father. Old Man River.
You know, Charlie, even though you tease me, I like you very much.
You do. That's good.
Doesn't she look nice tonight, Charlie?
What?
I say, doesn't she look nice?
Yes, yes, she does, yes.
Pretty as a picture.
Yes, indeed, yes. And the frame ain't so bad either.
Edgar, I thought over that card game the other night, and I came over here to return the money you lost.
Uh-oh.
So you're the queen that took Bergen's jack, eh?
Well, I want to give it back to you, Edgar.
Well, it's not necessary. You won it fairly.
Oh, you're very clever, but you didn't fool me.
No?
I just know you let me win it on purpose.
Oh.
Naive, isn't she?
What makes you think that I let you win?
Well, from those silly plays that you made.
Oh.
Please take the money back. I'll feel so much better about it.
Well, of course, if it'll make you happier, you can give me the money back. But I won't accept a penny interest, though.
I'm right of you.
Tell me, Edgar, did you really feel bad about losing the money?
Well, no, no.
Go ahead, act.
Yeah. Whatever gave you that idea?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe it was the way you lay there on the floor sobbing after you wrote the check.
Well, that's ridiculous. Money means nothing to me, nothing. Why, it's always easy come, easy go.
That's not the Bergen I know.
After all, what is money? I can't eat money. I can't drink money.
You can't spend it. You don't anyway.
Well, the game taught me a lesson, though. I'm just not lucky at bridge, that's all.
Bridge? No wonder you lost.
Uh-oh.
Everyone else was playing poker.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. Well, Veronica, just to prove to you how little money means to me, I'm going to take you out to dinner.
Uh-huh. I bet you wouldn't be generous enough to include me, would you? Oh, you wouldn't throw money away that way.
Yes, I will.
No.
Yes.
The man is mad.
Yes. Come on, get your hat and we'll all go.
All right.
Shall we walk? Take a cab or shall we walk?
I think we better take a taxi.
Oh, a taxi, yes. All right. I'll call one.
Taxi.
Taxi. Guess we'll have to take a bus.
Hey, buddy, want a taxi?
No, thank you. I never accept gifts from strangers.
Well, come on, let's all get in now.
Where to?
Oh, just drive down Hollywood Boulevard.
Okay, you want to go by Vine?
Who do you think he is? Tarzan?
Megan, where are we going to go? To the Sapphire Room or the Owl Drugstore?
No, no. No, I'm taking you all to my favorite restaurant.
No.
Yes.
Joe's Beanery is closed.
What do you say we go to the Macombadero?
Well, where is it, lady?
It's on the corner of Rod and Reel.
Yeah, down the line.
People will say we're in love.
Must be interesting being a taxi driver, isn't it, young man?
Oh, yeah, yeah, it is. You run into all kinds of people.
Oh,
there's one up now.
You'd be more careful. You have such a nice cab here.
Oh, thanks, lady. You wouldn't think I bought it second hand, would you?
No, I'd have sworn you made it yourself.
Well, here we are.
Never mind opening the door. We just went through the windshield.
Well, here we are. And this is one of the smartest places in town, Veronica. Well, now let's go in, huh?
I'll get some service. You let me handle it.
Yes.
Oh, gargoyle. You gargoyle. That's French for waiter. Gargoyle.
Charlie.
Huh?
A gargoyle is a hideous monstrosity.
Yeah, well, wait till you see this waiter.
Good evening. Do you have a reservation?
See what I mean?
No. No, I don't have a reservation, but I'm Edgar Bergen.
I'm sorry, old man. Ignorance is no excuse.
Don't talk to me like that, young man. It so happens I know the manager.
It so happens I'm the manager.
Oh.
Small world, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But I repeat, I'm Edgar Bergen.
You know I'm inclined to believe you. I don't think anyone else will admit such a thing.
Oh.
Well, I'm Veronica Lake. You should give us a meal just for the publicity.
My dear Miss Puddle.
Lake.
Well, have it your own way. You pay for everything here. Everything. Except the roof. That's on the house. Things I say, really, I should be on the radio.
Come on, Edgar. We're going to another place. I wouldn't step a foot inside this joint.
That's very kind of you.
Here's a taxi right here.
Well, hello, folks. Drew you out of there in a hurry, didn't they?
Why must we always get your taxi?
Oh, miss, I guess you're just lucky. I don't know.
Let's go to that nice seafood place. You know the one. It's on the corner of Hickory and Dickory. Near the dock?
Oh, yes.
Hey, what's the idea of driving so fast?
Well, I tell you, bud, my brakes are bad and I want to get home before I have an accident. I should be on the radio, shouldn't I? Well, here's the place, folks.
Ah. Well, I'm not going to get out here.
Well, why not?
Well, there's nobody there.
Why?
There's a sign. See what the sign says?
What sign?
Home cooking.
Oh.
Come on, Veronica. We'll go in anyway, huh?
Hello, folks.
Hello, Mortimer.
Well, Mortimer Snurd.
Yep, that's the way it is.
Now, don't tell me that you're running an oyster and clam place.
Yep.
You are?
Yep, that's the way it is. Yep. I'm in the old show.
Where?
I'm in the old shell game.
That's right.
Tell me, Mortimer, do you have any trouble getting clams?
I just work around here all day. What can we do?
Do you have any trouble getting clams?
Do I have any trouble getting clams? No, ma'am. I just go out on the beach and I make a noise like a lady clam.
Like a lady clam?
Yeah.
What good does that do?
I make a noise like a lady clam and the others come up to see what's cooking and they are. I ought to be on the radio. Pretty good.
Well, we'd like some seafood, Mortimer.
Yep.
Do you have eels?
I see.
Do you have eels?
Well, we had some this morning.
Had some this morning.
But they got away.
I see.
But they're on the menu.
No, they're all over the darn place.
Tell me, Mortimer, do you cook yourself? I said, do you cook yourself?
Oh, no. Once in a while, I burn my finger, but that's all. That's pretty good. I'll burn my finger once in a while. I like that.
Mortimer, how can you be so stupid?
Well, there's tricks in every trade.